next guest has been travelling the backcountry all over and knows a thing or two about music. Please welcome country music legend Graeme Connors to Studio 10. You are an absolute legend in the industry. You are.
Thank you for that, but I just keep thinking of myself as a worker. I just do what I do. I've been doing it a long time, trying to write songs that capture a bit about Australian society. And that's what country becomes, I suppose. You know, stories about us, we are.
You actually, speaking of being involved in songs and writing and being a worker, you also took You're the Voice to John Farnham, is that right?
That's almost like another life ago. I've been very privileged to work with songs since I got out of school, in fact. Yeah. And I had a sort of a period in my career where I thought, as a performer, I was it wasn't happening. Yeah. And so I moved into music publishing. And in that role, part of it was I would vet the catalogue, try and find recording artists for songs. The head of the Rondor music label in England, Stuart Hornell, came to Australia with two big reels of tape and said, there's a bunch of new songs here. Please see if you can find someone to record in Australia. Track one was a song called You're the Voice. And it was written by four British writers, Chris Thompson, Andy Kunter, Maggie Ryder and Keith Reid. I put it on and Chris Thompson, he sang the vocal for Blinded by the Light.
Oh wow.
Yeah, like, this is serious guys. And I heard You're the Voice, the demo. And it was like there was no one in this world that could do that song justice other than John Farnham. So Ross Fraser had been looking for material.
Wow.
Put it on a little cassette, sent it off.
Did he like it when you showed it?
Well, all I got back was a letter saying, please put this on hold. And then the next we heard through came the version with the bagpipes, which were an addition that I think David Hirschfelder had put on. And that was it. And wow. It was, I remember very clearly getting some lovely red wine and champagne from the company and a bonus for the year. So it was, I was just seriously though doing my job as a professional manager. That's what you did. You tried to either match an artist with a record company or a song with an artist. Mm. And it's these days so many artists write themselves or co-write with producers that role isn't fulfilled as much as it once was.
Mm. That's a perfect match. That was a match made in heaven.
Well, it was fortuitous. It really was that he was looking at that time and this song crossed my desk.
Yeah.
And
lightning doesn't strike like that all the time.
No, it doesn't, Peter. No, that was a beauty.
Way back in the start of your career, you were very close to Slim Dusty too. He played a big part.
Slim really brought attention to me as a songwriter. It was just prior, in fact, to moving into publishing. He recorded a song called I'm Married to My Bulldog Mac, which was a song of the year in the country market at the time and led to a friendship that I wrote 13 songs for Slim.
Wow.
And We've Done Us Proud is probably the one that most people know. It became quite an anthem. Mm. But it was wonderful working with Slim because he was a man who knew what he was going to sing about. And there's no point writing him a song about, well, I'm sitting at the bar having a drink and I'm chatting up a girl, you know. It was going to be Australian stories. Mm. He wanted to have characters. He wanted to have place, spirit of place. And the songs that I wrote for him, and so many writers will say the same thing, it was like he'd ring you up and say, I'm making a record about this. If you got anything, just put it through. A very generous man, always looking for outside. And he co-wrote with a lot of bush poets who created lyrics for him and then he would turn them into songs.
You've just released, for the first time in 7 years, you just released your own album.
Well, yes.
Number 18.
From the back country. This is, let's go 18.
18?
19.
The difficult 18th album? It took 7 years?
Well, not really, Peter. I wasn't sitting on my hands. The last album that I did that was all new material was The Speed of Life. And then I moved into a project that was a sort of a tribute to other Australian singer-songwriters. I really wanted to shed the light on some unknown and known writers that maybe hadn't had the breaks that I had. Then 25 Years of North, which was my landmark album, that came about. So we remixed and remastered that. Then that tour was highly successful, so I did a DVD, double DVD. And then someone turned 60, I don't know who it was, but someone turned 60 and we thought, what a great idea, we'll have a celebration, you know. So I wrote a few new songs for a double CD set called 60 Summers. And then I realised in February this year, Graeme, you're not doing your job. Where's all the new songs?
Yeah, right.
So it started again.
Oh, wow. Well, Graeme Connor's album From the Backcountry is out right now. For more info, you can head to GraemeConnors.com. You're an absolute legend. Thank you so much
well,
for
Sarah.
Stopping by. Having a chat.
Love you to have a chat.